Thank you. Good afternoon. It's a pleasure to be here, and it's a pleasure to see so many parents and so many students enthusiastically waiting to start on a new course of life. I welcome you to the journey, which many of us started many years ago, and I hope that it is as enjoyable, full of surprises and interesting times as the Chinese would say. Chinese might be here soon at the rate they're going, so I hope all of you are aware of what the options are and where life is. I have a long prepared speech, but I have the joyful announcement to make that I'm not about to make that speech, simply because though my colleague Anoop worked very hard on it, we've all decided mutually here that we will give brief 5-minute speeches and then allow you to ask questions. I guess that'll keep some of you awake in this post-lunch session and some of you alert, and maybe some of you the opportunity to actually hear the speech you want. I've spent a lifetime in journalism, and then I've now decided to run a communications company. I do what is called image management, a mixture of public relations and lobbying, a mixture which not anybody that I know understands, because I'm still trying to figure it out, and I'm supposed to be a reasonably pioneering company in this business. Fortunately, I have good colleagues, and good colleagues ensure that they come up with the ideas to make sure that the future is secure, and the business we are in is about both media as well as about management, but not exactly the kind of course that that is being introduced this year in media management. The advice I have for when you start like this is on the lines of what Pankaj said. You have to have a dream. You can't come here wanting to have just a career. All of those who are sitting here hoping to have a secure salary at the end of studying this course are in for a rude surprise. Your colleagues from across the road are likely to get larger checks than you to start with. They're also likely to have a few easier years initially to start with. After all, after a few years it all evens out, but the fact is that media at the start and media career, whether it's in public relations, whether it is in lobbying, whether it is in advertising, whether it's in hardcore media, is all about extremely hard work at the very start. So those of you who think that you've come in to see your names in the light, in the arc lights, are going to be sorely disappointed. Also, as Pankaj just mentioned, the fact is that in the media industry, it's a bit like the iceberg. You only see 10% above the surface of the water. 90% of people are doing their work and getting paid for it, but they're never seen. So the realization that you have to come to is that it doesn't matter. If you want to be in the media industry, as long as you are convinced that you want to be part of this huge iceberg, which is communications, advertising, PR, events, the whole gamut of it, and hardcore media, for 90% of you, the comforting factor, and I would say it is a comforting factor, is that you will live lives of anonymity, but hopefully will be able to contribute to society. This is where the edge is. In whatever sense you look at media, if you have a meaningful career in the media, you will be making an impact on society in some form or the other. Today, for example, when I stand here, I am busy juggling with another colleague of mine here a press release on a new computer which is going to be introduced in India's villages. So it is a one laptop per child computer that we are talking about, and we are working on this release even as we talk. We are changing things on the BlackBerry. So you are making communication steps which ensure that society is changed even as you are working. And this is the joy of being in the media business. The media business is a business which impacts ultimately the minds of people, the minds of citizens, and the minds of those who govern those citizens. Therefore you have influence, therefore you have a role, and therefore you have an opportunity. But the choice is whether you want to take that opportunity or whether you're here because you want a salary check. If it's a salary check you want, then you must look for media management as an option. Perhaps that will give you a larger salary check. But if it is excellence you're pursuing, if you're pursuing a career which makes a difference to your life and to the lives of those around you, this is a great choice. You've come to the right place, and I hope that you have a great time studying it. When I was looking at this audience of large numbers of students, the question that struck me was, what is it that I can tell you which might be useful, which might help you to start your course right? And I have only a few things to say, and I'll stop immediately after I've said those. The first thing is, please spend your time reading. For all those who can't read, who are bored by reading, you're in the wrong place. Watching is not good enough. YouTube and surfing the net is not good enough. That's the bad news. The news is that you have to start reading. And read, secondly, outside your comfort zone. If all your life is spent reading HT City, then examine your head and start reading something more useful. It's not good enough, and you're not going to get anywhere by reading some color supplement of a magazine, of a newspaper. You might as well read the property ads, and you won't get that either. The third thing is, examine your spelling and your grammar. All of us brought up on Nokia or whichever other T9 system that you use, think that spelling is something that you have finally got liberation from. The bad news is that you haven't, and spell checks don't help you determine whether hair is spelled H-E-I-R or H-A-I-R. So spell checks don't help either. If you don't have a language skill, and I don't mean just English language skills, Pankaj spoke of multiple languages, and in fact most of you need to be ambidextrous as far as languages are concerned, and we are talking Indian languages to start with. If you don't master writing, reading and grammar and spelling, you're not going to find a place in the media industry, irrespective of whether you are expected to hold a lamp, unless there's that job possibly. You know, the guys who used to hold lights for cameras, I don't think those jobs exist anymore, right? Now the cameras have lights themselves. So even that job is out for you. But unless you recognize that it is language, whether it is a visual language, a written language, a verbal language, if you don't have mastery of that, you cannot be in media. So please, if I were to leave you with one thought, it is this thought, which is that if you have to be in the media business, master the use of communication tools, i.e. the basic communication tool being language. Thank you very much. I'll stop here and wait for questions.